Hi, I'm Matt Letitia. Welcome to Biggleswade FC's YouTube channel. Here's the highlights.
For the invitation for the evening, you were asked to bring a pillow and a blanket with you. Have you put in your order for breakfast tomorrow? So I hope you're all prepared. So settle back, enjoy, and just let the hours flow past, and it will go past very painlessly. So really nice to see you all. So I hope you're all enjoying yourselves as we come together for our first Biggleswade FC presentation evening and celebration of the season. It's the first one we've held since 2019, amazingly. And it's absolutely brilliant. It's great to see everybody here this evening coming together. And I thank you very much for being here this evening. Spoken to a number of people. I'm completely blown away by seeing everybody here together. And a number of you have said, you know, to see the extent of the club and to see everybody coming together like this is absolutely fantastic. And I just say the obvious that 6 years ago we were founded. And look at us now. Look at this group of people here all together. So, to do with this evening, first of all, I'd like to extend my thanks to all the staff here at the Conservative Club, particularly Alison and Georgie, and also to committee members Ruth and Phil, who have worked so hard to put all the fine touches and all the digital details together. Thank you very much. So, since this is the first event for 3 years, I think it's really appropriate at the outset to wish all of you, in a very serious way, all of you and all your friends and family, everybody here, all well, and say how good it is to see all of you, what we've all been through over the last sort of 2-3 years in such difficult situation, unprecedented difficult times. It's fantastic that we can all come together like this. And I'd just like us to pause in all seriousness for a minute to wish all of you, your family and friends, and anybody who's gone through any particular hardship and real difficulties over the last 2 years, to say the thoughts and the sympathies of the club are with you. We are an FC family, and like a family we want to come together to support everybody. So I know people have been through very difficult times, and our thoughts and our good wishes are with all of you, and with family and friends and anybody who's been affected in an untoward way over the last 2 years. There are probably many individual stories, but I'd also just like to weave in, looking at Michael and Ian there. I'd like to send our very best to Frankie, who's just had her operation, and to wish her and to Dean and the little one all the very best. So on the football side, how good it feels also to have finally completed our very first season at Step 4. It seems like we've been around for much longer with those two semi-completed seasons, but it is only our fourth season in total. Just take that in for a minute. Four seasons in total, and now competing at Step 4 from where we started. It's absolutely amazing. And we can reflect on and celebrate how much we've achieved in this time. In 2019, in a much smaller venue here at the Conservative Club, and as you remember, it was a much sort of narrower room, I stood here speaking, and all of us were here, and there were five trophies behind us in that unprecedented season. At the moment, we haven't got any trophies here. I'm sure the reserves will have something to say about this in the Britannia Cup Final on Monday. In many ways, we've got so many more significant achievements to celebrate. We haven't got any trophies, but there's much, much more has been going on this season and what we've actually achieved. Think about what we've achieved, what the first team has achieved on the pitch. Ninth place for the first team in the Division 1 table. 60 points, 18 wins, only 6 teams in the whole league had more wins than us. 62 goals. Not a bad record, one we should be extremely proud about. And all of that after a difficult start to the season, coming out of COVID, consistency of the squad and other problems, and never being very far away, but achieving all of that after our start is quite remarkable. But I think really as important as that was how comfortable we now look at Step 4. Those of you who have seen us regularly, supporters, management, coaching, everybody connected with the club, how comfortable we look at Step 4. We're disappointed if we don't win every game, if we don't win every game with style. But do you remember when we first came into Step 4, we weren't sure how we're going to cope? It was a new experience. Teams are much more experienced, savvy, bullied us a bit and things like that. And yet now how comfortable and how assured we look. We've never been far away, have we, in any of the matches this season. Remember, Bedford had a pretty easy run of things in the league, but how close we ran them and how deserved was that draw in front of our record crowd. We can hardly put our finger on the games where we weren't outplayed. We may have lost and got no points, but we were so close. How comfortable and how assured we look at that level. And at the same time, not only gaining results, but playing with our usual trademark ethos of passing, of teamwork, entertaining and delighting all of those who watched our matches, always trying to play in the right way, which gained so many admirers. Our squad, so much deeper than previously, options all over the pitch, and giving every team in the division again. To give you an example of that, I'm sure you know that on Monday, Ware are actually in the playoff final. Can you remember how we beat them so easily at home? And how we deserved, more than deserved, a draw away from home? They're in the playoff final. Fine margins. First season ever at Step 4. Just shows how close we are. But we have everything, don't we? We have the results, we have the depth of squad, but it's also the way we play. Nobody ever says we're boring or dull to watch. Sometimes it works for us, sometimes it doesn't. We play in the right way. The reserves team, we've mentioned about how well they've, again, a little bit of a sticky start, but how well they've motored through in their results. What a delight it is to see those young players playing for each other, scoring so many goals, encouraging each other on to the last. Fine win today, by the way, and how much we're looking forward and anticipating the Cup Final on Monday. And then this year, of course, only in our fourth year, I'll keep emphasising that, we've acquired youth sides. We've got the under-9s, we've got the under-11s and the under-18s, all doing excellently in their respective leagues, being challenged by playing at higher levels, all of them playing with the FC badge and playing in the FC way and securing the future of the club. And now, news also, you may be aware, we're going to have an under-7s team as well from next year. So no trophies, but just reflect on what we've achieved on the pitch. And what about all the brilliant people associated with our club? So many of them in the room here this evening. The committee, the volunteers, sponsors, supporters and backers of our club. What about the public faces, I term it, of our club? How we're perceived by other clubs, by the league, by our visitors. Our recent being top of the hospitality. We don't just invite people to our club on match days, officials, and stick them on the table and leave them to talk to themselves. We talk with them. We interact with them. We ask questions. No wonder that we're perceived in such a positive and a friendly way. So what I like to think of is that on the surface, we don't have the trophies. We haven't achieved that, but we've achieved so much more. I talk in a way about us thickening out as a club, about us developing, about putting roots down for the future. Much, much more significant. It means much more to belong at this level and to feel comfortable at this level and to compete with anybody at this level than just one single achievement. And I think that's one of the biggest things that we've learned and developed over the last few years. It's superb in its own right, but it's also a wonderful platform going forward. Many of you have heard us speak about the bigger picture, and I think it's worth dwelling on that for a minute because it's so true all the time. Just imagine, just think for a minute about walking up a hill or walking up a mountain, and it's tough going, and sometimes you stop and you get tired or you feel you can't go on or there are obstacles in the way. You're forever gazing at the distant horizon, thinking you're never going to get there. Some people are going faster, some people have got up much easier, and you think it's an endless journey, and you wonder, you know, am I making progress? And then you stop, and you turn around, and you see where you've come from, and you see the valley floor way below, and you realize how high you've climbed, how quickly. Have you had that experience when you walk up, and you don't realize how high you've got in a short period of time? Isn't that a very suitable metaphor for us as a club, how far we've come and how important is the bigger picture? And the bigger picture is so important. You know, football is a very short-term game, wins or losses, but never to get too up when you win, never get too down if you lose, because overall the trajectory, the pathway is up, up and up, and you keep doing things in the right way as we are and things will fall for you. And I've saved the best till last on that because all of this, all of you being here, all the sponsors on board, all the way we've played and the things we've achieved, all of this without the elephant in the room, all of this without having a home of our own. For the first time, being out at Biggleswade, ground sharing, as a fledgling young club, what a risk it was to go out of the town. So we've done all this, and we haven't just risen to this challenge, but we've got so many of you coming along regularly to support us at Bedford. And we're growing and thriving whilst not having a ground of our own in our hometown. So I think that's remarkable, quite remarkable. Something very special is happening here. And each one of you are part of this. You're making history. You're making part of this very, very special journey. Who knows what we could achieve when we will have a home of our own. And these roots we're putting out. You're all part of it now. And what an exciting, what an incredible future. What an incredible pathway we're on because of the foundations that we've set. So just pause for a minute. Can we just a big round of applause for everybody in here and everybody involved. And just to add to that, I thought it's worth sharing with you something that all the committee know, and that it's important in any organisation, and people far more experienced than I will know this, but to have an ethos, to have a vision for a football club. It's a very immediate game. You win, you lose, you draw, it's to do with the league table. There's something much bigger. It's about ethos, it's about vision, it's about belonging. So we have something we call the FC Way, or our vision statement, and I'd like to share it and remind each of you about what we're trying to do. So our vision statement says that we're more than a football club, that our aim is to develop, establish and sustain Biggleswade FC as a community football club, offering the opportunity for progression for talented local footballers. The club aims to do things in the right way on and off the pitch, playing attractive, passing football, and always both respectful and hospitable to supporters, visitors and opponents alike. FC engages and supports the local community of Biggleswade and endeavours to create a friendly and welcoming football family with its players and supporters working together to achieve success. That's what we're all about. That's what we're all about. So, don't panic. That was the first half. I'm now come out for the second half. I've been refreshed in the changing room. I've had a pep talk from Dave and Skip and James, and I'm ready for the second half. So, with this overall perspective, this second part of what I want to say follows two familiar lines. And it's going to get boring because it's the same thing for different groups of people. And the line goes, well done and thank you. So it's well done and thank you for all these different groups. Wait. First of all, I'd like to say congratulations and well done to all our players. From the first team and the reserves, it's brilliant to see so many of you here tonight. Also to the young ones, the youth, who are not here this evening, but are very much part of the club. Thank you for your time, effort and commitment, and for playing the way you do, and for entertaining all of us, and bringing us such pleasure. I was able to go and speak to the first team before the last home game, and just to reiterate that point, to say, we really, really appreciate all your time and commitment. We can sit in the stands and say that was a good pass, or why didn't you do that and that, but just stop and think for a minute what these people are doing on the pitch. And when it is windy and it's a horrible pitch and it bobbles around, they're playing for us. They're trying to do things, not just play, but play in the right way. So thank you to each and every one of you players here tonight. And not just on the pitch and for what you do, but for all those hours you spend in travelling, sometimes for midweek matches, when you've got work commitments and other things going on. We know that. We get that. And it's even more appreciation for all the time you put in to entertain us. And also for playing the way that you do. As I said, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Who cares? You play the right way and you'll succeed phenomenally more times than it doesn't work. You play the right way. We can all think of examples where we watch teams win, but we hate the style of play. Am I right? It never happens with us, and we might slip up. Even when we go and get matches going right for us, we attempt to play in the right way. And I think that's absolutely fantastic. And also a thank you to all the players for forging such a wonderful relationship. And it's a kind of two-way relationship with the fans and the supporters. I hope you know how much the supporters and the committee and the volunteers value what you do. I hope you can feel those vibes from us. And equally, you are so personable, you're so friendly, you form such great links, the conversations you have, you really make it very special for the people watching you. And again, I said this, and some of you heard me say, it's absolutely fantastic how people just stay behind, and we want to win, lose or draw. When you come off the pitch, we're there to support you and to encourage you. And of many, many examples I could choose, I think that example, that Welling, when we didn't have the best game, and we were a bit off, and they were up for it for the playoffs, and we lost heavily. And they won, and there wasn't a Welling supporter in sight, but we were all there in our green and supporting you and cheering you off. And it didn't matter, because we appreciated what you do. And I hope you feel that. And that two-way relationship is absolutely priceless. Because I have to say, we go to a lot of grounds, but you don't get that. People just disappear with the final whistle. And many of you have commented how you see the sea of green and supporters everywhere. So that is really, really special. That's something you can't just magic up, but we've got it. So that two-way relationship is so powerful. And we always capitalise on what we can do well. There are some things we can do as a club, and some things we can't do, because we're very new and young, and we're like a little plant just growing, fledgling plant growing. But one thing we do have is this wonderful spirit and this relationship, and it's the envy of many clubs. So well done, and thank you also, obviously, who guides and supports and coaches and encourages and boosts and puts sometimes an arm around people when things aren't going well. It's of course our fantastic management and coaching team. Thank obviously Dave and Skip and James and Connor and Amy and Phil and Matthew and Ollie and all the people who put the time in and the skill with which you handle and deal and talk with the young players. It is about football, but as Matthew has reminded me, the difference between management and coaching, it's also about the whole person. And about doing the other things, not just on the football field, but encouraging on the person. And people, you are the evidence. You want to play for our club. And that says volumes about the guidance and the support that you give them. I also think it's fantastic. And now I'll get to the point where I'm allowed to present a few awards before I hand over to Dave and Skip and to Phil. It's a great pleasure also, the continuity in our club. That we've got people playing who were there right at the beginning. And some people have already, in a very short period of time, accumulated a very impressive CV and lots of appearances under their belt. So it's a delight and a pleasure this evening to acknowledge that. So first of all, I'd like to present this. Our 100 appearance cap, delighted to present two more of these. We did a few in 2019, but I'd like to present these caps to two stalwarts who've got 100 appearances for FC and never disappoint with their performances week on week. So I'd like to put your hands together. There's 100 appearance cap for Michael Simpson and Keane Coles. Our young club, we've got people who show their commitment by racking up even more appearances. So the next thing, I know one person is here, I think the other person isn't, but two of our first team squad have achieved 150 appearances, and those two players are Pat and Nathan. I'm not sure Pat's here, but Nathan, come on down. I hear you say. No, it is. isn't it? Because remarkably, in our short time as a club, we also have somebody who has racked up 200 appearances. So let that sink in for a minute. And as a personal aside here, I think I speak for Ruth as well, when this player always comes on the pitch, not only for the service he put in, when this player comes on the pitch, I always feel a kind of reassurance because I know he's going to keep the ball, close control, run with the ball and look threatening. So it's absolutely with great pleasure and delight, give him a big round of applause, 200 appearances for Ryan Inskip. And we have an order of caps in ready for the next ones in line, so don't worry about that. Now, I hurried on, and you might have wondered, he hurried on past the management, and you thought, is that it? But now we come to Dave and Skip. So, what can we say about Dave and Skip? There will now be a 2-minute break while you write something down on a bit of paper. It might be a limerick, a pun, or just a bit of abuse, something like that. Well, let's take Dave first of all, please. No, seriously, Dave. One of the good things, of course, is now it's summer and now the grass is being cut, we can see Dave a little bit easier. Said there, me the giant saying that, but anyway, I'm fighting, I'm going to get it later. Also, I must commend your burgeoning radio career. You appear with great regularity on Radio Biggleswade or FM, whatever it is. There you are, turn the car radio on, and there you are, the radio star promoting the club. And in all seriousness, and I say this, that you speak very well, really concisely and summing up all about our club and everything is absolutely fantastic. So I think you've done a brilliant job. So, Dave, you're very, so important, not only in obviously setting up the club, but all you do in terms of nurturing and encouraging players. And something that you won't say publicly, but I'd like to acknowledge, is that your generosity in so many ways towards the club in ways that we don't see or don't know, that is fully appreciated. What I really like about Dave is that how he and I always see eye to eye on our judgments. I've come to learn that if I think a particular player has played well, Dave will have him at the bottom of the list. If I say that's been a good passing match, he'll grimace and say, we didn't pass it at all. So it's quite a useful rule of thumb. Whatever I think, I know Dave thinks the opposite. And that's not a bad point of reference. I also like his relentless optimism, the way that things are going to turn out well. That's what I really admire about Dave. Now, Skip, different kettle of fish. What I like about Skip is that the way in which he always gives officials the benefit of the doubt. He always understands that referees and linesmen have a difficult job, and if it goes wrong in one match, he'll leave an out over the season. After an extensive period of counselling, he's finally got rid of all the trauma about not progressing past the quarterfinals of the FA bars. We finally got there. And you know, Skip will say, Jeremy, it's just another match. The Now, in all seriousness, these two people are so key, aren't they, in so many respects, and we respect and thank them so much for all that they've done for the club. Who would have known that we were in the back of a car on that sunny afternoon making our way to Wembley in 2016 that we'd be where we are at the moment? And of course, all the guidance and support that you've done over that time. So it's a great pleasure for me, I'd like you both to come up here. We have a presentation for both of you to celebrate and thank you for 250 appearances in charge of FC. Said a thanks, well done, a thank you to all our match day sponsors and season long sponsors, all our backers and supporters, anybody who's ever bought a lottery ticket and put money into the club, 50-50 draw, all of the people who have backed our club, you're really, really important and we thank you for everything you've put in. I'd like to thank our vice presidents, Terry Winter, Nick and Michelle and Mick, for our support and guidance and putting into the club. Chris, our cameraman extraordinaire. Bernard and Andy for supplying food and refreshments on match day. Thank you, appreciate it. Welcome to FC and Barton family. And also, he doesn't have this official title yet, but I'm hoping to get him, can I call it our official FC photographer, to Guy in the middle there. Fantastic. And last but of course not least is all our supporters and fans, all of you here this evening and others who couldn't be here this evening. Thank you for your amazing home and away support. As I said before, coming out of town, our attendances stand up. We're about ninth best, I think, in the league, with about 150, 160. Amazing, amazing support. Thank you. And it's always great when you get people wearing the colours and you don't know who they are, but they're just wearing our colours. That's when we've really arrived as a football club. It's invidious to name people individually, but I just want to make particular mention of Norman and the Green Army. And I want to make mention of the three amigos, two of whom here tonight, Ian and Michael and Dean in his absence. Forgive me, I don't mention everybody, but I would like to mention Tracy and Anthony for taking a lead also in selling of the merchandise and the first steps in our superstore. A final word to thank my amazing committee that we've got, all the hours that they put in, all the hard work, all the public face of the club they put on show, everything they do. I think I'm right in saying, aren't I, that we're so much happier on home match days now, and a whole raft of worry and stress has been taken away. So thank you to everybody who's put in all the time on match days and in between. I'm not going to mention people individually, that's invidious, so I'm going to mention them all. So I'm going to thank Phil Gulliver, to Lee, to Faye, to Dave, to Mark, to the two Roots, to Cherry, to Terry, to Sharon, Paul Ison, to Ray, to Sarah, to Wayne, Paul O'Brien, Phil Smales, to Matt, James and Paul Darlow. And can I add to that also our fantastic volunteers who have helped out, to Kirsten, to Keely, to Natalie and to Jackie. Can we give them all a big round of applause? The other thing that falls to me is this club, I know I'm way over, I'm sorry, called the Clubman of the Year, which is, I get the prerogative to choose. And I mentioned before about the public face of the club. It's often said when you go to organisations, you form an impression by the first people you meet, how they project the club, how they talk to the club. And this person literally is one of the first people that you meet. He is our meter and greeter. And unfortunately, sod's law, he can't be with us this evening because of a long delayed eye operation, and he is really upset about that. But we will be obviously presenting with this in later. So you're either all sworn to secrecy, or I'll have to give the game away anyway in a WhatsApp chat or at the AGM. But I really enjoy the conversations before matches with this person. I love his enthusiasm, he's amazing for his age, he's going to be 90 in a few months' time, and we've helped him, I think, as a family, give back his love and his commitment to football. So it's brilliant to award the Clubman of the Year for this season to Terry Curry. Just finally to conclude, I just want to say a very quick word about the future. Our ground share with Bedford may have been great for us, but it was only ever part of a two-part plan. We need to be back in Biggleswade. We need a ground of our own, and we're working tirelessly to do everything we can to do that. But as you know, things sometimes move quite slowly, and sometimes you take one step forward and two steps back. But we will be coming back, hopefully, sooner rather than later. Our focus, relentlessly, is on Biggleswade while we're out of the town. But to take a word from the sort of marriage vows, you shouldn't engage and set up a football club lightly. You have to be thinking of the future, you have to be thinking beyond. So this is my appeal to everybody here and people that you know, that any way you can support and to help us with offers of expertise, in terms of funding, in terms of sponsorship, can you bring other people along to our matches to grow our growing fan base? Can you help us in any way, and can you support us in our quest to actually get a ground of our own? And we will get that ground of our own, and we have to relentlessly focus on that end vision and what we're actually going to achieve. And I'd also like to say, again with a view to the future, and this isn't for now, but we have to think about something called succession planning. We have to think about the future of the club, not just for now, but in 5-10 years' time. So this is an offer, if you want to be involved with our club, and I'm also looking at players who at one time will come to their end of their playing career who might be interested in helping the club in different ways. We're always thinking about the future, not just the here and now, and we want to make sure those roots we're putting down are yielding things in the future. So we're focused upon now, but we're focused also upon the short term and the longer term future. So any help you can give us to help us grow even more securely, we would value your input. We're always pleased to hear from you. So I'd just like to conclude at last by saying thank you once again to all of you and to people who are not here this evening, and well done. We have tickets for the comedy night in 1 week still on sale. That should be another fantastic evening. Before that, we have the Cup Final on reserve. Let's all get behind the lads and get them to lift that trophy on Monday. From me, I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening, however long it is, after I finish speaking, and celebrate all our achievements. A huge thank you to everything you do for our club and that you will do in the future. And to, just to remind us again of going back to the sort of marriage service, can we all do a toast? Can we raise our glasses and toast Biggleswade FC?
Well, Jeremy, thank you to Jeremy.
Oh,
Fundraising, the administration, the coaching, the first class social media exposes all of us to a lot larger audience. And of course, Chris doing an excellent job with the exposure we get from his hard work filming and editing games. I'm sure you will all agree, we can all be very proud of what we have built and we continue to build together. Whether you be a player, a coach, maybe someone who makes the tees or mans the turnstiles, this commitment from us all makes this club what it is, special, and gives us all the sense of worth and belonging. So I'd like to thank each and every one of you for, on behalf of the reserves, for giving us the opportunity to be part of this club. As with any success, behind it is good planning, hard work, lessons learned from previous seasons, and then that then used as a base to build from. After winning the supplementary Premier Cup at the end of last season, we not unexpectedly lost a few players to other higher step clubs. And obviously little Jackie Dreyer moving up to the first team. We picked up a few more talented young Biggleswade lads in Alfie, Chris, Josh, and young Taylor, also joining after rave reviews from Connor. And after finally getting fed up with playing for teams that promise so much on social media but never delivered on the pitch, we were lucky enough to add Ross to our ranks. For us, the season has not yet finished yet. Our first season at Step 7 is encouraging to see we should finish in the top three. We've reached the Britannia Cup Final and also the quarter-finals of the County Cup. If Kieran had read the text correctly and not turned up with a car full of players at a home fixture when it was an away tie, maybe even further in that competition. It has been trying and tested at times this season for all of us, but always an honour and a privilege to work with all these young players who we have great hope for and who have never let the youth of this club down. What the squad has gained in experience this season will stand them in good stead going forward, knowing not one team we ever played against played us off the park. We never let teams bully us, but we just kept playing the football we all enjoyed and we reaped the rewards. We may not have a ground to call home, but these lads got on with it and gave their all for the club on the pitch, getting complimented everywhere we went and the way they conduct themselves. So a big thank you to everyone who made this possible again this season. So let's start with the awards. The first award we've got is the Why Me Trophy. The Why Me Trophy. There were definitely a lot in the running for this. Joe, Pabby, Seth, Chris, etc. I don't mind seeing passion from players, but we had some full-scale tantrums. Some wobblies thrown over the season, which every daycare nursery in the country would have been proud of. In the end, it came down to two players, both very good young players, a forward and a defender, both with bags of talent and great potential. But what tipped the scales in the winner's favour was his relentless and admiring mission to never understand why me. After every explanation we offered, so we'd like to give Sammy to come up and collect the award.
Yeah, why you?
Right, next up. Most generous contributor to the fine pot. An award the rest of the players really appreciate. Only one winner here. Serial lateness for everything. From turning up to games, to replying to texts with the worst excuses, toys out of pram moments, salts when left out of starting after being away previous week. So the rest of the reserves would like to thank Kieran for his absolute vote again this year. 12 players getting votes from over 30 supporters. One player narrowly pipped the rest with his silky skills, entertaining all season. He's instrumental in the success of this side on and off the ball, always returning a good goal tally for the team and continues to improve season after season. So he... So it gives my great pleasure to present sports player Kean Coles. Next up is our young player of the season, which is presented to a player who we normally present to someone under 20. Because of what we've all been through and then endured for the last couple of years, and having no presentation evening, either we did not want this lad to miss out on an award he should have probably won already. I can quite honestly say he's the most polite, hard-working, dedicated lad that we should be proud of to call one of our own. He rarely misses training or matches, and from his first training session has blossomed into a strong, pacey fullback that has a better six-pack than Huntley. It's with great pride and honour I would like to have Musa Jamal Pabbi to come in. Three of us, but in the end it was quite an easy choice. This lad, I'm sure, will not mind me saying, has been through a lot in the last 2 years. He will openly admit he thought he was at rock bottom. Only his determination to succeed and overcome got him through the situation he found himself in. He didn't shy away from making the changes he needed to make. He got the right support from the right people and made the right decisions. One of them joining us. And hopefully he has benefited from this choice. We definitely have. We couldn't have asked any more from him. A tower of strength which his teammates took up. It's an honour to present him with the Manager's Player of the Season, Chris Richardson. Managed to stay fit all season, didn't go off missing to any festivals. His performances have been excellent all year. He's had a good goal return for the team. He has fleeced most of the squad week in, week out for the fine pot and made sure the change room is always buzzing. So I'd like to present Players Player to Oz. Easier. They've been outstanding this year and what they have both contributed to the team and the club. So big thank you to these two.
Well done, Lisa. Well done. Good luck on Monday as well. We'll all be there supporting you. Well done.
I believe Skip is up next. Of course, the first team rules. Yeah. Christmas.
Peace.
Yeah, sure.
Good
She punched him, and then she told Skippy, they're getting married, and Skippy said, okay. And the last one is Phil, and Phil's quite a simple tale. When he was at junior school, he fancied the teacher. I'll hand you over to Skippy. Just quickly, I'm going to skip. Just want to, I know a couple of you boys will appreciate this, but I brought one of these to help me with talking to Skip, because I had to try and work out some of the words he used in the changing rooms. One of the words being ferocity, which we've worked out might have meant ferocity, and the major important one he uses all the time, which is iterate, which we believe is reiterate.
So I'll be getting it from Jeremy and Dave. When Jeremy said in his speech he's at half time, I wasn't expecting extra time and a replay and extra time in that replay. And Dave, you're going to get it in a minute. Can I just say, firstly, supporters committee, I know it's been said before, it is appreciated very much. Also like to take this opportunity to congratulate three of the lads who become fathers this season for the first time. They've started, Tom says. Can I just also thank James Petty for all the coaching, etc. And I think, under mine and Dave's guidance, he is improving. Slowly. New players this year we've joined. Jack Lewis, Jack Wilson, Luke Middleton, all from Stevenage, who over the time improved us, to be fair. Others, Johnny Butler, Charlie O'Keefe, Reese, Adam, Danny Bonus, and Ross started with ourselves as well before an injury curtailed with us, but he's improving every time. I'd also like to thank Alex, Dan Green and Laurie for coming back to join the exclusive club. George Bailey in it, but now we've got a good five-a-side team there. Yeah. Right, first prize, hopefully the video is working. This is best Sunday morning footballer. There are six nominees, which surprised me, six nominees. Now, one of them, George Bailey, continually talks about his goals, his assists, and etc., etc., and he uses Saturdays just to warm up, keep fit. I didn't realise others played, and then Jack Dreyer, somebody declared he's in a cup final, and scored. Is the video working? Here we go. Hold on one sec, please. Chris, hold on one sec. You're going back, are you?
Right, hold on.
On Jack Dreyer's there when he said he was playing on a Friday night. He scored that night. I didn't realise the game went into extra time and it finished in the very, very early hours of Saturday morning. The six nominees are as follows. Chris.
At dere ikke får lov til å begynne å spille før laget har gjennomsnitt 1 i promille. Hver målscorer blir testet, og hvis han har 1 eller mindre i promille, så blir målet
etc. His brother is the manager. Best Sunday League footballer, George Bailey. Next award, quote of the season. There was an incident two or three weeks ago. two months ago now that got me thinking, and I thought, yeah, there's some mileage in this. So what we've done is I have sat there and listened to different people over the last 2 months, and I've listened to their quotes and their sayings, and this is the list. There are 14 nominees. Chris, see if you can guess them, lads, as they come up. None of mine. I've got my own award.
Oh, that's me! Shotgun!
Who's that?
100%
me! John Carr.
Stand by it. Jack Prayer!
Who's that? Who's that? Next one. I'm all right so far. Something, I ignored it. Dave nibbled. He said something back. Dave said, I don't care, I'm a millionaire. Two weeks, he bounced the ball, looked at Dave, said, well done. Played on. I just stood there, I've never laughed so much in my life. So the winner, Dave Norfield. Coveted Owen Dixon Award.
chosen by Sharon. When the photos come up, I apologise because there are all photos of our new tattoo, tanned, dyed-haired version, Sharon's mislaid. There are numerous people that we nominate for this award. 6 years on, most of the lads used to be down the gym regularly, working out, etc. But there's only one now. There's a few still go to the gym, but only one continually talks about his abs, gets his abs out. It's his answer to everything. So, numerous nominees.
Go on.
Make them clean, please. Young Mark's in the background. I forgot to mention some of the quotes we didn't hear this season. One of them, good goal, Nathan. Adam, I'm on penalties. Match day, sorry I'm early, Dave. Next one, goal of the season. Goal of the season. Now, on this, it's only possible to show this because of Chris's dedication coming to all the games, or most of the games. I was concerned with Chris, he's an endangered species, being a Liverpool fan, hadn't seen one for 30 years.
And you're not going to for a long time.
But he's captured most of the goals this season. We're going to go through the nominees, there's 12 of them. Over the last 3 weeks, I've asked numerous people their version of what they think is the best goal, isn't the best goal. It got a little bit cloudy, to be fair. Dave went Lee. To be fair, I went Ryan. Laurie went Alex. Alex went Laurie. Tom Coles went Tom Coles 1, 2, 3. Actually, he said Tom Coles, Romania, 2, irrelevant, 3, who cares? Romania. Chris, if you could play it, this is the nominees.
Would you think of me? Would you buy another gun? I fall to my knees and I say, please don't take me. They keep on, and on. Well, I'll
Exercise is good to get everything back. And before we do the three main ones, the last trophy is for, and we're doing this one because of being diverse and what have you, so we include everybody. And this is best player playing with a handicap. And we've got a few nominees for this one. Players, we're just trying to be fair, players that turn up for us every week and have got issues of sorts that affect their game, and I'm just, so we're going to be honest about it, but you know, when I think what they go through to play like it, beyond belief. So if I can give you the nominees, Adam Hunt, he plays every week knowing that he's spinning on the back of his head. In that same group as Bondi and Ryan and Skip. Johnny Butler every week plays. Every week he plays. And he's worried about either one of his shiny teeth coming out or mixing up his Botox in his cheeks. Tom Coles plays with her every week with a massive problem he has every week. Split personality. One moment he can be a great footballer, the next minute he become a 12-year-old kid. Reese, new player Reese. By the way, fantastic complexion. But I've now witnessed this twice. I know no player's ever witnessed this. I have. I've gone into the changing room twice. He sneaks in when you're doing your warm-up. He sneaks in because he's struggling. He has a split personality. And I've caught him twice in the front of the mirror going, walking away. Nathan George plays with a bag back every week, carrying his nose. Jack Dreyer plays with depression every week. His dad was a pro. His brother's a pro. His sister's stunning. I know he can claim he scored on a Sunday morning game. Big ones, Laurie Marsh. Laurie Marsh has to play every week, being known as Alex's brother. I'll come back this up because I read the Twitter for Richard. When Alex left, it was wishing Alex all the best, how great, how brilliant he was. When Laws left, they just said Alex's brother's left. And I apologise for this, but Alex has to play every week knowing his brother's shit. So the winner of the player playing with the biggest handicap, Alex Marsh. Supporters Player of the Year. Do you want to speak about this?
No.
Supporters Player of the Year, so we can't blame for this. And what I will quickly just say, I personally make sure I knew of nobody had won this and nobody who had ever won the Players Player. We kept it all quiet so we got things right. So, the supporter. I was quite good on the previous one. Yeah, thank you. Anyway. Oh, God. Can you be quiet? He's going to be a 12-year-old man. Supporters, players, player of the year, Adam Hunt.
Have a word. that? What's the
side again. They were always in the side,
but we just lacked a little bit of confidence. When Alex started scoring the goals, we all raised that game. You could actually see we could win games. We're better than most sides in this league. I've always said that. We should have been in the playoffs as a minimum. I'm hoping they'll be like that for next year. When the players voted, it was very tight. But Alex Marsh, 2021-2022, Players Player of the Year.
I have also Cherry. Where's Cherry? fucking man gets all my goals. By the way, mate, my speech was going to be a lot nicer. And I come second with my second best goal.
I'm skipping.
Absolute ridiculous judgment. I fucking lost it.